This is what Chris Nylon usually does for the Canadiens. It's his job to take on the other team's tough guy, be Montreal's policeman. During the playoffs, though, this born-again fighter is now a checking specialist, shutting down the Whalers' top line.
No, it's not like I need anybody to do my fighting for me, but it's just kind of, it's not sensible for me to go off the ice when I have a job to do in checking the high-scoring line with Carbonneau and Gainey. And if I'm not there, not to say that Lucien Deboire can't do the job, but I like to do that job, and I like to keep the big line off the board. And, you know, if I'm sitting in the penalty box, it's hard to do.
Enter John Kordick, a big defenseman who racked up more than 300 penalty minutes in the minors. The Canadiens' coaching staff brought him up for one reason.
They called me up to play tough, and I don't want to let them down by getting knocked out or losing a fight or something. And get the team down and stuff. The team thinks I'm supposed to be tough. And if I get in a fight, I want to make sure I get the better half of the fight. So, because the players are looking at when I go on the ice that if I get in a fight or something that I do well.
Kordick hasn't let his teammates down. In the first round against the Bruins, Nylon's bodyguard pounded Boston's resident goon Jay Miller. In the Adams Division final against Hartford, Kordick has taken on Torrey Robertson twice. Each time, the NHL's most penalized player was roughed up by the new kid in town.
John Cornish, the kid from Edmonton, handles himself pretty well in what for him is a normal situation.
The Canadiens seem guilty of exploiting Kordick, turning him into another NHL thug. But Kordick disagrees. He says it's the chance of a lifetime.
It's getting me a start, you know. I got drafted because I could fight well, and I got called up a couple times because I could fight and play tough. And, you know, Chris started that way, and now he gets to play, so I have to start that way. And if that's what they want me to do it for, you know, for the first year or so, that's what I'll do to keep me up here.
So Chris Nylon's new bodyguard is on duty for as long as the Canadiens need him.